In this video, we'll discuss using the Automatic Exterior Dimensions tool. You can find the Automatic Exterior Dimension tool by going up to the CAD drop-down menu to the Automatic Dimensions Parent tool, and then here in the Child Tools, you will find the Automatic Exterior Dimensions tool. Or you can find the same icon here in your toolbar for quicker access. When I click on this Parent tool, you will find the Automatic Exterior Dimensions Child tool in the Child Tool palette here on the left side of your screen. When I click on this tool, Chief Architect will place dimensions to all the exterior walls and place them on the exterior side of the building. I'll delete one of these walls and notice now that my exterior dimensions will not generate. You'll need to make sure that you have proper room definition by enclosing all sides with some type of wall for the Automatic Exterior Dimension tool to work. When you use the Automatic Exterior Dimensions tool, the appearance of the dimensions will follow the active dimension defaults. In this case, my 1/4 inch scale dimension defaults are active. If I change the active dimension defaults to the 1/8 inch scale dimension defaults, and use the Automatic Dimension tool again, all of the automatic dimensions will update and you will notice that now my text is larger and my arrows are different because they are following the 1/8 inch scale dimension defaults. Let's draw one manual dimension line here. And you will notice that the color of this one is red. If you go to the Edit drop-down menu to Default Settings, click on the Dimensions, then double-click on Dimensions here, you will find all of the available saved dimension defaults. I'll click on the 1/8 inch scale dimension defaults and click Edit to see what these settings are. The dimension defaults determine the line setup, the format of the dimensions, the objects that will be located by the dimensions, what the extension lines will look like, what layer the dimension line is placed on, the arrow style, and the text style that is used. Notice that the layer that the 1/8 inch dimension lines will use is a layer I have created called Dimensions 1/8 inch, and this layer is red. But if I close this dialog, you'll note that the manual dimension line I've drawn is red, but the automatic dimension lines are not. They have all the other characteristics set in the 1/8 inch scale dimension defaults, but not the layer. That's because the Automatic Exterior Dimension tool has its own default settings. If we go again to Default Settings, to Dimensions, and then to Automatic Exterior Dimensions, you can see that this tool will override only two of the characteristics set in the active dimension defaults. The Automatic Exterior Dimensions will determine what objects are located. The only objects that will be located are the walls and the openings. You decide if and how you want those objects to be located. The other property of the Automatic Exterior Dimensions is the layer they will be placed on. So even though my auto dimensions look like my 1/8 inch dimensions, they are not red because they are on a different layer. Once you have placed auto exterior dimensions, you can edit them by clicking on a dimension line and moving it. Or you can add or remove extension lines. You can also open the specification dialog specific to this dimension line and change its appearance. However, once you have edited a dimension line, it is now customized and is no longer following the automatic exterior dimension defaults. Also, it will not be deleted and updated like the others if you use your Automatic Exterior Dimension tool again. When you have placed dimensions, you can use them to move the walls into the precise location that you want them. Click on the wall that you want to move, and then click on the dimension number that you want to change. I like to move in a clockwise direction around the building as I move my walls so that I don't inadvertently move a wall that I've already moved into its correct position. For instance, this dimension is correct and this dimension is correct. If I click on this wall and change this dimension to correct that number, it's going to change this number as well and mess up the correction I've already made. So if I move around the building in one direction, I can avoid moving walls repeatedly. You can delete the automatic exterior dimensions all at once by going to the Edit drop-down menu to Delete Objects. Select All Floors here, and then select Automatic Dimensions. Then click on Delete. That will delete only automatic exterior dimensions. It will not delete any single manual dimensions that you have placed. Now I'm going to open the plan that I've added openings and other objects to. Let's place automatic exterior dimensions on this one. You will notice that the dimensions are not locating the doors and windows. That's because I have changed the automatic exterior dimension tool defaults and removed the check mark for the openings. You will also notice that the deck railings are not dimensioned. A railing in Chief Architect is a type of wall, so why wouldn't the automatic exterior dimensions locate them? This is a case where the tool defaults are not making that determination. That is a setting in the wall type. If I double-click on these railings to open the Railing Specification dialog, you will find the option for No Locate. That will make the Automatic Exterior Dimension tool ignore this type of wall. If I uncheck this box and regenerate my automatic exterior dimensions, you can now see that the railings are dimensioned. Again, the Automatic Exterior Dimension tool and the Manual Dimension tools will locate objects differently, because they have their own individual default settings. My automatic dimensions are not locating the cabinetry, but if I draw a manual dimension, this tool will locate the cabinets. Using the automatic exterior dimension tool is a fast and easy way to dimension your overall plan, and understanding the differences in the auto dimension tools and the manual dimension tools will help you get the exact results that you want in your building plans.